I'm Ilyan St. Hilaire, and in this video, we're going to talk about MeshCentral.com, the public MeshCentral server. MeshCentral is, of course, a free open source software for remotely managing computers that you can install on any server and remotely manage your devices. But there is also MeshCentral.com, which is a website, a specific website that I manage for remotely, for of course, downloading and getting information on MeshCentral, but also it's a public server you can use for free to manage computers. So let's take a look at that for a bit. What I'm gonna start by doing is opening a browser here. And I am going to go to, of course, MeshCentral.com. And this is the front page of MeshCentral. It has, management features, the security features. If you haven't looked at that, you should. The security features, of course, have a nice PDF with lots of the different features that MeshCentral has security-wise, and of course, manageability-wise, PDF with just the overview of management features for MeshCentral. On the top, you have different screens. You can quickly take a look at what MeshCentral looks like. There's a downloads. This is where you can get an idea of how to download the installer or how to install MeshCentral. And then you have documentation on the right, lots of PDFs on user guides, install guides and stuff, including the Android APK. Then there's YouTube, Twitter, and the blog, GitHub and NPM. Those are all the websites that either talk about MeshCentral or you can get more information. So this is really the front page for MeshCentral, but MeshCentral.com is much, much more than just this front page. On the upper right, there's the public server login. And if you click on that, you can create for free a user account on MeshCentral.com. You will have to validate it with an email address and get a confirmation. And then once you're done, you can use MeshCentral. This is not a demo version. This is an actual instance. It's running for real and it's running for free. Now, obviously, you won't be administrator on that instance. I will. But so you'll just get the user privileges, but you'll be able to install devices and remotely manage them as you would a real MeshCentral server. Because this is a real one. So if you want to just get an idea of, well, is MeshCentral good for me? Or maybe you have just a few quick computers you want to try out on, then this is a great option. You don't need to install your own server. There's one public you can run. Now I'm gonna log in here, Ilyan, and let's see. Now, of course, I use two-factor authentication. Oh no, wrong password. I'll try again. There you go. That will be better. And of course, now it's asking me for a token or a security key. I'm going to use my FIDO key. They're about $20 or $30 on eBay, and I highly recommend them. You just press a button and boom, you're done. And so here you go. I'm logged in my account. This is the regular MeshCentral server. There is one difference though between this one and one you would run. If you click on a device group, you'll see here user consent, and you are required on MeshCentral.com to notify the user when you do a remote session, and also the connection toolbar at the top will show up. So a remote user can close that to kick you out if they don't like you. So that's kind of a requirement for the public server. I don't want anybody abusing the public server to control computers they shouldn't be controlling and stuff like that. So one way to mitigate that is to kind of force user notification on that instance. Now, of course, if you install your own server, you get to control these the way you want. You're not required to force that. But for the public instance, just to make sure that people are not using it in a bad way, this is what's required. Otherwise, all the features are pretty much as you would expect. You can put your logo here, you can change languages, you can create login token and so on and so forth. Now, One question that people would have is, well, why are we running a public instance of MeshCentral? Like, what's our goal? And a few things. One is that now we have an instance that runs in the real world, so we can connect real world data. And so I'm going to pull up here some just two slides I have. This is the current data from MeshCentral.com, and it's running about between 7,000 and 9,000 agents. So I'm guessing there's about 10,000 agents, that are connected to MeshCentral.com. But about at any given time, there'll be between 9,000 and 7,000 that are connected at any given time. And you can clearly see the weekdays, it goes up and down, and then weekends, there's these valleys here. And then sometimes I update the server or I work on the server, and so you see these little weird things in the graph. But otherwise, this gives us a really good real-world data on how effective the server is. Is it running well? Is it running, does it have a high CPU load, or is it scaling correctly, and so on. Now, here, the other numbers are really small compared to the number of agents, but you can click on the logarithmic scale, and you'll see that there's about between a little bit more than 200 Intel AMT connections at any given time. This again is where I did some fix up to the server. And I don't touch the server very much, but sometimes I have to. And so that's what happened here. And then you'll see user sessions are about 100. They go down to 50 and go back to 100 here. But that's the number of users connected to MeshCentral at any given time. And so, yeah, I'll take a look at the control panels, and at any given time, I'll have about 50 to 60 users that are connected on the server. And then they're doing, these green relay sessions, which is remote desktop and remote files and so on. And so that's what's in green right here. So one of the reasons we run the public server is to basically make sure that the implementation runs well, that it's stable, that there's not too many problems. So that's one way that I like it. The other thing I want to check is right here. This is the MongoDB free monitoring website. And this is the one for MeshCentral. So I'm showing you live data right now. And so if you are not familiar with this, if you're running MongoDB as your database, starting with, I think, MongoDB 3.8 or 4.0, you can turn on this free monitoring service, and then it will send data, and it will give you a URI you can access, and you can see this data. So you can see that for currently 60 users about logged in, for about 7,000-8,000 computers, agents connected to the server. Well, we're going to take a look, at what's going on here, and you will see read writes to the database are sub 1 millisecond access time. Sometimes you see these spikes. Usually the spikes have to do with the daily backup of MeshCentral. So MeshCentral by default will auto self backup once a day, and so this is what you see on the spike there. Otherwise, disk utilization, we're talking 1%. Documents returns very small. Memory, up counters, let's see. Query targeting, this I look at a lot in to make sure that my indexes and my database is running really smoothly, close to one. That's exactly where we want to see it. And you'll see CPU usage here. It is, basically around 3-5%, except during the backup, of course, then it goes up, but otherwise it's very small. Okay, so now one other question a lot of people ask is, okay, so you're running about 10,000 agents, 7,000 to 9,000 agents connected at any given time. This is the data you're getting. Where are you hosting this, and what instance are you running? So MeshCentral.com is hosted on AWS, and it's running on a T2 large instance. So let's take a look at AWS T2 large. And I should get here, if I go down this page, there he goes. So a T2 large instance has two virtual CPUs, 8 gigs of RAM. So, you know, basically this is like a decent Raspberry Pi will, you know, has more CPUs in the same RAM as this. Now the credits per hour, so it's about 9.2 cents an hour to run. So that's what we pay. So if you look at, let's see, the calculator, 30 days in a month times 24 times 0.0928. So it's about $67 a month to run that server, plus traffic costs, of course. And actually, the traffic cost is higher than the instance cost for MeshCentral. So what's interesting here is that you know, any effort we make in the code to reduce the traffic that's sent outbound from the AWS instance, then the less the instance will cost. So, you know, doing compression, WebSocket compression, compressing the updates, compressing the mesh cores, using WebRTC, and so on and so forth. Everything we can do to minimize the amount of traffic being sent by that server obviously will lower our hosting cost. But you'll see that I used to run a T2 medium, and with the amount of agents we were having, the problem is that we didn't have enough RAM. So here the problem is when you scale up, the CPU is not that big of a deal, but really the memory is the big deal. So so if you are, you know, going to scale to very large amounts of agents, make sure you have plenty of memory. Okay, let's see. So I answered the instance we're running on, how many people, and so on and so forth. We do expect it to, you know, I expect it to be running for many, many years to come. There is obviously no guarantee on the public server. You know, it's a service that's free. There's no guarantees. If you are, you know, running a business, you know, the preference is that, or, you know, you're doing something critical, or the data is critical, then much, much better to run the your own instance in your own cloud. This way, you own everything, and that way I don't have to do anything about it. The other thing that I want to talk about is the data that we gathered from this. So, because we're running this public instance, because it's loaded, because there's a lot of users using it, one thing that's interesting is we're constantly able to optimize the server and to make it faster and faster. So this is really good. The other thing I want to note is that MeshCentral, let's see if I can do this here. I'm going to go to my developer instance. And you'll notice that when you click and you say check server version to update, not sure if this is going to work here, but maybe not, but usually there's, there it goes. There's the stable version and there's the latest version. And the rule I have for the stable version is if I upgrade meshcentral.com and wait about a week to 2 weeks and there's no problems, then that becomes the stable. So what's interesting is meshcentral.com basically becomes a guinea pig for a version I pick. And then if that if MeshCentral.com runs for a while and it seems stable and there's no problem, then I will go in npm and tag the version of MeshCentral as the stable version. So this is kind of my criteria. So you can kind of safely assume that when you see stable version and you see a version here, most likely that's the version that MeshCentral.com is also running. It's not always the case. Sometimes, obviously, I'm making modifications to MeshCentral for optimization purposes or you know, development purposes, or sometimes it's testing the newest version. But in this case here, it is almost correct. The MeshCentral.com, as I'm recording this, is running 0.952 with some modifications that I made that are coming up in newer versions. Okay, so hopefully that was clear. That was MeshCentral.com, the public MeshCentral server. Hope that was useful. Take care.